It is revival time with Elder Michael G. McCray. We're here for the lost, the needy, and those that don't have a church home. Stay tuned for Elder Michael G. McCray.
Number one, Romans chapter 8 and beginning at verse number 1. And also, if you would like to have a CD copy of the radio program, you can write us at 313 Vine Street. Make a donation of $8, and we'll be so happy to send you a CD copy of the radio program or whatever finances you can give. We will be so happy to receive it and send you out a CD copy of the radio program to bless you in Jesus' name. Romans chapter 8 and beginning at verse number 1. The Bible says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walks not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. My wife and I, Pastor McCray, would also like to thank Pastor Early Neal and Pastor Roosevelt Neal for inviting us to their church celebration on yesterday. We are thanking God for you. We had a wonderful time, and we're thanking God for you in Jesus' mighty name. Today, we'd like to talk to you today, my friends, being free in the things of God. Being free in the things of God. In these last and in these evil days, my friends, freedom is coming to our lives, and it does not seem as though we're receiving the freedom of God. But the freedom of God, my friends, is for each and every individual that walks upon the face of the earth. You can be free in Jesus' mighty name. You see, my friend, in society today, people want to put things over on you and put weight on you and try to make you bogged down in these last and in these evil days. But the Bible says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, which means I'm free in my mind to worship and to magnify the name of the Lord. You see, my friends, the enemy does not want you to be free, and he wants you to be bogged down, and he wants you to not be able to worship and to magnify the name of the Lord. But in these days and in these times, my friends, I'm here to tell you that you can be free to worship God in spirit and in truth. Our pastor, my wife, Deborah McCray, teaches us at the church that you can worship God there at the church however you need to. You can worship, and you can just let God have his way in your life. See, my friend, today people want to keep you under condemnation to make you think that you've done something so drastically and so terribly that you cannot magnify God, that you cannot get God's forgiveness and get God's grace in your life. People today won't forgive you for what you've done. People today won't forgive you for what you've said. People today won't forgive you for how you've done things in the past. But the Bible said, there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus, who walks not after this flesh, but after the Spirit. See, for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me to be free, hallelujah, in my mind, free in my walk with God. I don't owe no man nothing but to love them. Glory be to God. I don't owe you nothing but to love you. I don't owe you nothing but to give God praise for you and for...